Please stand for the opening prayer and the singing of the Philippine National Anthem.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our most gracious Heavenly Father, we come to you today to praise and worship you and give you thanks for all the things you continue to provide for ourselves and our families. Father, we humbly ask for forgiveness for all the times you have offended you. Continue to guide and protect us, Lord. Bestow upon us your unending grace and healing, that we may in turn become instruments of gentleness and compassion to others. We ask all this in the name of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, with prayer and intercession of our Blessed Mother. Amen.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. اللهم إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اللهم اهدنا الصراط المستقيم اللهم وحد صفوفنا بين المسلمين والنصارى واللوماد إلى صراطك المستقيم اللهم امنحهم العيش بالأمن والسلامة والتنمية المستدامة في مدينة داباو اللهم لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار والحمد لله رب العالمين.
Amoy nen manama kami gimu tolango manotod ka karosono si koy kau kami toku tolango way migtumpi to tano si koy kau kami bohoy tapopi anan tolango na maoto pusako kapusuno kana akong to pabulos ko'y agbuyo ko'y kaway bahay kat pabor kahalaan kalinaw tao kanami na pag-ugpo way kasapaka ko'y ayot kalambu kay kura tamana kakodin panubad way pag-ampo kaupianan ni bahay no way kakoy kong imono way kahalaan kalambu
Kababayan, ang pambansang awit ng Pilipinas.
Hayang mag-ibig, tebas ng sinanganan, alam ng puso, sa titik mo'y buhay. Upang hinirang, tuyag ka ng magiting, sa mandulupin, di ka pasisigil, sa nagatak tutok sa sibuyan.
Now take your seats. The Commission on Higher Education, as an agency that is in charge of promoting higher and relevant tertiary education, acknowledges the importance of conducting off-campus activities that allows the students to explore different learning opportunities outside the university. This morning, officials from the CHED Region Office 11 will provide a comprehensive explanation in the processes and guidelines in conducting off-campus activities. But before that, let us hear first the welcome address of the Director of Office of Student Affairs, Associate Professor Maria Stella R. Salazar. A round of applause, please.
Thank you, Bea, our very reliable host of the Office of Student Affairs. Okay? So today, we will have a review of the rules and regulations regarding off-campus activities. Okay, and since the time I echoed that the orientation I received last November in Coronadal at the farm, many questions have arisen. Okay, so this thing is not new to us. I remember there was a time that all off-campus activities were banned, and then suddenly it was allowed, but there were so many requirements requested. And then during the pandemic, there's no off-campus activities because we are all off-campus. No, we are all working at home, we're attending online. Now that the pandemic is over, we started going back to school and planning for our activities. So kasama rin doon yung ating mga off-campus activities, the things that we need our students to experience and learn. But then probably the rules that was set during the 2017 policies on off-campus activities were siguro na hindi na remember or something. That's why we have different reactions to the rules, which is just a reorientation, supposedly. Na it was there before, it was not lifted. And Ched is telling us, please follow. So ngayon, ang daming questions na naibigay at na nag-arise, which I cannot answer. We are fortunate today. We have a resource person from Ched Regional Office 11 to tell us or to explain to us the things that we are questioning about these rules, these policies. Okay, so we have right now with us the education supervisor two of Ched Regional 11, which is in who is in charge of the criminology, engineering, and architecture programs. She is also the focal person for student internship and educational trips, both local and abroad. So please welcome Engineer Maria Cristina B. Condes from Ched Regional 11. Please.
Okay, so to the Director of the Office of the Student Affairs, Dr. Maria Stella R. Salazar, ma'am. So I believe wala si Chancellor and si Vice Chancellor. Okay. Okay, that's okay, ma'am. Sige po. To the faculty, the rest of the faculty na nandito and staff of UP Mindanao, most especially the students, no? Both on-site and online. So marang ang setup ninyo is hybrid. So it's okay, no? So thank you for the invitation sa aming office. So this is actually part of our technical assistance. So it's okay to invite us, no? So but we usually do orientations every year. So before mag-start ang school year, we do orientations. But because mayroong special request ang OSA ninyo, of course, it's a good opportunity also to assist specific schools, no? Especially kanang kailangan na ang presence ng mga estudyante. So we do orientations, Manggod, usually sa mga focal persons sa inyo ang mga schools. But it would be a good na chance na meron pang mga estudyante. I don't know if you have parents na mag-attend, ma'am? No, wala naman po, even sa online. Yeah. So, parent. So may representative ang parents. Yes. Okay, so I am here to present to you the details of the CMO 63 number series of 2017. That's our policies and guidelines for local off-campus activities. So meaning we have a separate na policy for international, and then we have a separate policies also in other na mga off-campus activities such as the internship and ano pa yung isa, no? So meron tayong mga different. But we will see ano ang covered ng CMO 63 kasi nakalagay local off-campus kasi, no? So let us see ano yung covered niya. So let me share muna my slides. Okay, so our policy for policies and guidelines for local off-campus activities is CMO or CHAD Memorandum Order 63 series of 2017. So this is in accordance with the pertinent provisions of RA number 7722, otherwise known as the Higher Education Act of 1994. Ay, na-arrange pa. Okay, so Batas Pambansa Bilang 232 of the Constitution, which states that the state shall exercise reasonable supervision over all higher education institution, higher educations. Commission and Bank Resolution Number 540-2017, dated July 18, 2017. So the following policies and guidelines on local off-campus activities are hereby adopted. Okay, so prior or pinaka-latest na CMO or policy namin, before nag-lift yung sa ating activity sa off-campus, kasi na-mention ni ma'am, especially nung pandemic, is na-ban ang ating mga off-campus. Hindi naman siya totally na-ban, but meron lang mga restrictions. Like, kailangan magpaalam pa sa, approve pa dapat sa LGU, yung mga activities ninyo, kung safe ba. So, may mga ganun na mga restrictions. So, hindi siya sa lahat ng activities pwede, no? So, but when the CMO number 1 series of 2023 came out, ito yata yung na-orient kila ma'am sa Coronadal, no? Ito yung amendment to Article 4 that letter E of CMO number 9 series of 2022 on local off-campus activities. Ang nakalagay doon is that kailangan approve ng LGUs, as I've said. But with the amendment, ang nakalagay ngayon sa CMO 1 series of 2023, local off-campus activities including but not limited to educational tours, degree program relevant events, field study, mission-based activities, seminars, conference, community outreach programs, performances, competitions are allowed subject to compliance of HEIs with the provisions of CMO number 63, series of 2017, otherwise known as the policies and guidelines for local off-campus activities. So other activities undertaken outside HEI premises and not covered under CMO number 63, such as internship, practicum, and OJT training, OJT, are allowed subject to compliance with the separate existing CHED guidelines, no? So as I've said, meron yung silang mga separate na guidelines. But what was emphasized in CMO 1 is pwede na ang local off-campus activities, no? So hindi na siya limited to approved lang by LGUs. Okay, so ito po ang content natin. These are the articles incorporated in the policy. So isa-isahin, except na lang yun sa mga hindi na kailangan, no? So we will i-emphasize natin yung mga important ones. Okay, for the rationale, that's Article 1. So in the Philippines, HEIs ensure sustainable teaching and learning delivery process through the conduct of off-campus activities. These are activities conducted by HEIs to supplement and facilitate a more meaningful learning experience for students in addition to the regular classroom instructional programs that are in accordance with specific degree program requirements. So these also include non-curricular activities. So they are intended to broaden the students' learning opportunities and allow them a feel of the real world, and therefore serve a powerful motivator to strengthen the academe-industry linkage. This learning situation includes internships, educational tours or field trips, field studies, educational linkages, student development activities, non-curricular based activities such as mission-based, immersion reach-out programs, conventions, conferences, trainings, volunteer work, inter-school competitions, cultural performances, and team development activities, among others. For the statement of policies, Section 1 states that CHED recognizes the academic freedom of the HEIs in promoting quality education for the continuing intellectual growth, the advancement of learning and research, and the education of high-level professionals while enriching historical and cultural heritage through the conduct of off-campus activities as part of the curriculum. Section 2, all HEIs are given the authority to design, determine, and approve the conduct of off-campus activities as part of a duly approved curriculum as noted by CHED, as part of the HEI's particular context or respective mission. Such authority of the HEIs, however, shall be exercised with paramount consideration given to the safety and welfare of the student participants. Section 3, it is the obligation of the HEIs to adapt mechanisms of safety and welfare of all participants to the off-campus activities and observe due diligence and strict adherence to requirements stipulated in this CMO and the Joint Memorandum Circular. Section 4, to ensure the well-being and safety of all the students in higher education and guarantee the quality of their learning and exposure. CHED, in partnership with some of the government agencies, such as the Department of Tourism, no, LTO, LTFRB, and more, no, shall issue separate guidelines for the conduct of all off-campus activities, if needed. Article 3, Section 5. So this set of policies and guidelines aim to guide HEIs in the conduct of off-campus activities in order to develop the holistic experience of students and to provide, number one, access to efficient and interactive learning to students through meaningful off-campus activities as part of their program requirement embodied in the approved curriculum. Second, quality of off-campus activities necessary to acquisition of relevant knowledge, skills, and values. Third is the mechanisms to exercise due diligence prior, during, and after the activities for safety and welfare of the students and HEI's personnel. Fourth is the mechanisms for the implementation of parallel activities to those students who will not be participating in the activity. So in short, hindi siya pinugsanay, no? Okay, so ano ang covered sa CMO number 63. So sa prior, previous na CMO sa local off-campus, only the field trip lang ang emphasized doon. Now in CMO number 63, 2017, covered na lahat, both the curricular and non-curricular activities. No? So these are the examples of curricular activities, yung mga educational field trips and tours, So yung mga educational field trips and tours, yan yung mga visits to reputable firms or government sites and other areas identified by the concerned LGUs, safe for students. So culture and arts related activities such as visits to museums, cultural sites, landmarks, and other related venues. Another sample of educational tours and field trips are the plant visits. So usually mga engineering ito, no? Engineering, plant architecture, no? Plant visit, industry visits, host training establishment visits, and other related visits. So another curricular activity is the participation and or attendance in degree program related events. No? Another is yung field study, experiential learning, related learning experiences. Later, i-ano natin yan siya, kung ano yung mga ibig sabihin niya ng mga activities, no? Samples of non-curricular activities, yan po, no? Mission-based activities such as retreats, recollections, etc. Conventions, seminars, conferences, symposium, trainings and team building. Volunteer work, including peer helper programs, relief operations, community outreach and immersion, advocacy projects and campaigns, participation in sports activities. Oh, yun na, si Ma'am Varsity kanina, yung nakausap ko. No? So, non-curricular yan siya. No? Activities initiated by recognized various student groups, inter-school competitions, tournaments, culture and arts performances, and competition. Okay, so let us define some of the terms na naas sa ato ang CMO. So approved curriculum. So if tanawon ninyo ang prospectus na naitatak sa CHED. So ang pasabot, gi-evaluate na siya and then gi-approve na, nag-follow sa minimum requirements set by the commission. So yun ang approved curriculum, no? Curricular activities, required off-campus activities which are integral part of the instructional program, meaning sa inyo ang silabay, nakabutang dito, required ang off-campus activity na specific. So in engineering, kasi engineering, as an engineer ako, no, nakalagay talaga doon, we are required to mag-attend or mag-participate in a field trip. No? So ang pag mag-organize ang program namin, pwede yan siya within lang Davao, or within the region or outside the region. So depende kung ano po yung na set ng program, no? So that is an example of curricular activities, no? Okay, so ang difference ng educational tour and field trip, kasi lagi minimension dalawa, no? When you say educational tour, it refers to off-campus learning activities involving mobility of students with the supervision of authorized personnel outside the premises of the institution, which lasts for more than 1 day. So 1 week. So hindi siguro 5 months. Kaya murag internship na, no? So usually 2 weeks. 2 weeks, seldom lang na mga 3 weeks, 1 month, no? Murag ang 1 month, dili na siguro na siya tour, no? Murag nag-unsa naman ka, no? Nagbakasyon, no? And it involves relatively more places and destinations than a field trip in accordance with the degree program requirements. Dapat required sa program. So, dapat well-designed siya na activity. Field trips, so usually, ang duration niya is 1 day and mas less ang destination niya, no? Pag field trip. Ang field study, experiential learning related learning experience refers to off-campus activities which are congruent to the learning outcomes of the course in terms of time and context. So these activities require substantial off-campus learning as curriculum delivery. So meaning, di ba, sa inyong silabay o daily activities ninyo dire, mauning mga lectures ninyo, and then part of that is kanina day, dapat mo add to mo dito kay mag-observe. Oh, so those are field study experiential learning. So ang uban, nag-gather of data kay research ang subject. Oh, so that's kanina mga adlaw, oh, these are your days na kailangan ninyo mag-gather of data. So those are examples of field study and experiential learning, mga related learning experience. Okay, institution, of course, UP Mindanao is one of the HEIs, higher education institution, recognized by CHED, no? Non-curricular activities or non-program-based activities which are left to the discretion of the HEI. So ito po ang part na sa academic freedom ng school na mag-identify, mag-determine, or mag-design ng mga activities na based sa inyong mission, no? Kay kanya-kanya mang mission ang mga school. So, di po naka-align ang inyong mga activities, Ana. The whole year. So, dapat naka-design na siya, no? Okay, so off-campus, of course, yung outside sa inyong school. So kung nandito lang ang gym, pareho niyan. Kung yung mga varsity, dito lang gym, wala na. Alam, mag-parental consent pa, no? Nandito na sa loob ng institution. Pero the moment na magawas na sa gate, that's already off-campus. Magwalis-walis ramudiha, no? Kasi anytime, simba ko lang, no? May may tabo, pagtabok lang outside sa gate, simba ko lang yun, no? So that's already liability ng school, no? So ang school will be held accountable for that, no? Okay, so exclusions meaning walay appeal, dili covered sa ato ang CMO 63. Again, ang international educational tours and field trips, so naalay mga particular schools na pwedeng maka-conduct og international educational tours and field trips. That's part of CMO number 26 years of 2015. And of course, yung para sa internship, OJT and practicum, which is the whole SEM, or more or less more than 1 month yan siya i-conduct outside of the school, no? So that's a separate CMO. So we have two, one for local and one for international. CMO number 104, 2017, series of 2017 is for local. That's CIPP, no? And then for internships abroad, that's CMO number 10, series of 2023, no? So that's not these are not covered sa atuang CMO 63. Okay, for Article 7, so we have Section 10. Kani siya ang mga partner nato na mga government agencies. So ang CHED, of course, is ang pinaka-chair sa ilahang team, no, sa committee. Department of Tourism, because some of the activities, magkahinanglan o mga travel and tours ng mga agencies. So, dapat accredited manguna sa DOT, no? Department of Tourism, no? Especially, kailangan mga naay mga permits na siya from DOT. DILG, of course, LTO, kasi pag mobile ang mga bata, sometimes magamit og mga vehicles na dili owned by school, but mas maayo if owned by school. But of course, you have to check if pwede ba roadworthy, meaning okay ang kondisyon sa sakyanan, no? So naan yung mga permits na kinahanglan from these agencies like LTFRB, no, LTO. So kailangan na ng mga permits sa inyong, especially the driver's license of the driver, no? So those are mga katupan naman ng concern ninyo, no? Daghan kay documents. Okay, so siguro naalay mga assigned people naman talaga na mag-take care of that. So if the driver na siya head, the head will take care of the documents para sa inyong safety. So everything boils down sa safety sa students and sa faculty na mag-uban. So mauna, that's why na yung mga ingani na mga documents. So I hope ma-understand na later on, no, sa mga estudyante nato na nag-comply. Okay, so Section 11, isa-isahin natin later ang responsibilities and obligations and the requirements of the school, no? Section 12 will be the responsibilities and the obligations and the impositions of sanctions for the students who will not comply with the documents. Okay. So for the responsibilities and obligations of the school, so ito po, so the HEI shall design, determine, and approve the activities for the conduct of off-campus activities in accordance with the curriculum requirement and or HEI's particular context or respective mission. So their design should include the relevance of the activity to the program. So dili lang basta-basta magbuhat og activities na para lang mag-enjoy, no? So kailangan na ay relevance yun sa mission sa school. And of course, if you are sa program itself, no, katong sa kurso ninyo. If you are an engineering, dapat relevant sa engineering. Architecture, dapat relevant sa architecture ang inyong gidesign na activities. Okay, second is adapt and implement its own institutional policies, including adherence to requirements under this CMO as part of its duty to observe due diligence in the conduct of off-campus activities. And then failure to do so shall be a cause for imposition of the sanctions as provided in the CMO without prejudice to other liabilities under applicable laws, no? So kailangan naagyoy policy ang school. So, naami policy sa CHED, but it should be incorporated sa policy sa school na dapat nakikita ninyo sa mga manuals, like the student handbook. So, kanina medyo hiningi ko yung manual ni ma'am, no, student handbook. So, wala pa doon ang policy ninyo and guidelines for the off-campus activity. That is for your guidance kasi, no? So, if wala kayong ganyan na nakalagay na policy, so walay accountability na mangyayari. So what if may mangyari sa inyo sa labas? But meron mga na-release yata ng mga memo, so siguro yun siya. But better if meron tayo mga general policies na lahat ng students will be given, no, yung mga guidelines. Dapat nandyan ang off-campus activities ninyo na guidelines, no? Okay, so designate the personnel in charge with appropriate qualifications and experience, and when necessary, identify an overall leader for among the PICs. Okay, PICs is personnel in charge. So I think ang pinaka overall as I ang OSA office, no, so si ma'am siguro, pero depende pa na ma'am, so depende kung giunsa ninyo pag kasi kailangan may designation talaga eh. But I a lot of the schools, majority of the schools, talagang sa OSA office yan siya. Kasi it's student affairs, no? Basta, per program, no? Kaya mga kurso ninyo, meron niyang personnel in charge. So, a faculty, kasi mas technical, no? If architecture, it should be an architecture faculty. Pero under sila sa pinaka personnel in charge ng off-campus activities, both local and international. So, sa inyo ma'am, sila pwede silang mag-gather ng mga documents for you and then isasubmit sa inyo. Sila magde-design ng mga activities because program-related, isasubmit sa inyo and then kayo na lang po ang bahala mag ano. So, meron yan siyang level-level. So, baka kasi mahirap din kay ma'am kung siya lang isa. No? Diretso sa kanya ang students. Diretso sa inyo ma'am. Non-curriculum. Diretso. So maybe you can revisit that ma'am kasi kung by course merong program in charge na faculty, mas lesser ang inyong ano ma'am kasi yun ang ginagawa ng ibang schools. No, so meron. Oh, so yan ma'am para ma-lessen ang ano niyo kasi ang administrative work ninyo is grabe na. So siguro medyo i-lessen yung mga workload ninyo sa when it comes to yung facilitating sa mga designs and everything, no? So baka pwede siyang ma-revisit ang inyong inyong policy diyan ma'am, no? Okay, so ensure 1:35:50 PIC student ratio. So ilan ba ang classroom class size ninyo usually ma'am? 35 to 50, mga ganyan, no? Malaki na 35. Wow. Very ano naman dito. So usually mga 50 yan eh, 40 to 50. So yan siya, so manageable ang inyong mga classes dito ma'am. For non-curricular activities sa HEI because hindi siya for curricular kasi usually it's required the whole class. So medyo bigger. So non-curricular, so medyo hindi natin alam ko, no? It varies kung non-curricular. And then ensure safety and mobility welfare of mobility of students through the following transportation. So, owned by HEI. So, dapat yung updated, valid documents pertaining to registration, insurance coverage, driver's license, assurance of roadworthiness, among others, shall be insured. If third party, meaning nag-rent mo og sakyanan, or naamoy third party na gina-coordinate for the transportation, the same, no? Pero, ang ano doon is dapat ang franchise na asila yung updated franchise sa LTFRB or travel and tour operator duly accredited by the Department of Tourism shall be insured. So, meron lang additional for outside. So, just make sure na pag ma-accidente ma'am na ay liability ang inyong third party, no? Kay lisod na siya, no? Okay. Coordinate with the appropriate LGU or non-organization NGOs. Kasi sila ang merong listahan ng mga areas or mga places dito na safe for students. So dapat mag-coordinate sa inyong mga local government units. Para in a way, informing them na naay mga estudyante na muadto dito ng mga place within their katang ilahang covered na areas, no? Require the students to submit a written consent of the parents. Murag kaniyang dako og issue, no? Or students' guardian and medical clearance if appropriate. So we will talk about it later. No? Establish mechanisms to provide parallel activities. This is very important. Important, no? Parallel activities. For curricular and alternative activities for non-curricular, which provide similar acquisition of knowledge and or competencies to achieve the learning objectives for students who cannot join the activity. So these parallel activities shall not be made a substitute of a major examination for the purpose of compelling students to participate in the said activities. The HEI shall only impose acceptable measures and non-punitive activities to concern students. So dapat dili siya in a form of punishment pag dili ka mo attend, no? So pag dili ka ka-attend, but it has to be a valid reason, no? Kay requirement man siya sa isa ka subject, no? Or it's an activity na gi-conduct sa school, so dapat it has to be valid, like medical concerns, no? Medical na kay dili ka pwede kay medyo heavy ang ano, or na is money can be a reason, no? Kay dili man mo pwede pugson, but if the school must be ready with the parallel activities na same ang makuha ninyo na competencies if you have joined the outside na activity, no? So again, i-ano na mo sa amo ang morphe kanang among manual of operations na ang grades sa mga bata such as exam dapat performance based. So kaning pag attend ninyo outside activities is dili ni siya performance based kanang ano gyud, no? Quiz performance based gyud na. So dili mao na ginaingon diri na dili i-substitute ang examination sa inyuhang outside activities kay dili na siya performance based. So you are just there para murag i-supplement lang, na supplementary lang na mag-go out mo and learn something from outside, and then ano lang yan siya, real world lang yan siya ng mga experiences na kailangan ninyong makita. But not necessarily the performance based na kailangan nato tanawon ng mga scores ninyo, no? If you have learned sa inyuhang academics. Okay, so kada lang kay para ma-note lang sa mga students, no? Okay, so give due considerations to students or learners with special needs or persons with disability. So it has to be stipulated talaga sa manual of operations kung ano yung mga privileges sa mga PWDs. Kay dili gid sila pwede, no? Mag-attend. Not unless na kanang moingon sila okay, no, maka-attend sila. But they have the special na mga privilege when it comes to these activities, no? Conduct of off-campus activities that shall not unduly benefit or accommodate any of the establishments owned by HEI or CHED employees and officials or by an owner who is a relative within the third civil degree of consanguinity or affinity. So meaning, kunwari travel and tours, basig ka mag-anak na sa taga-CHED, basig ka mag-anak na ko na, no? So meaning, mga misyon pa ko, no? So dili dapat related sa mga teachers ninyo na mag-uban sa ano, or sa school, dili dapat connected sa school. Kay para walay ano, no? Walay issue, no? Tama, no? So, but bawal talaga yan siya sa CMO. That's part of the policy. Okay, so these are the requirements na kailangan isubmit, no? Sa CHED, no? Before, dapat kani check mga checklist ng before, during, and after. Pero what are those yung mga may annexes kasi na attached dito sa CMO? Pero what are those activities na kailangan lang isubmit sa CHED? So meron kasing mga activities na dapat required ang school na mag-submit ng Annex A, Annex B, and Annex C sa CHED. And what are those na diri lang sa school? So pero tanan activities ninyo required og kanang documents, no? So dapat na-add dito sa inyong handbook. Okay, so these are the annexes na naasa. These are the reports na ginasubmit, no? Required sa school, no? Ang Annex A is ang Certificate of Compliance, duly notarized. So later I will show you the template. So ang mga signatories diha should be certified correct by the personnel in charge. I believe this is the director of the OSA. And then I recommending approval from the VBAA, si Ma'am Chancellor yata to, no? And then of course, approved by your Chancellor. That's 15 days prior to your activity. And then, ang report of compliance checklist ni siya, no? So meaning, katong ganiha, nang ipang mention ako, and then naapo na dito sa Section 11. Annex B na siya, no? Nag-check sa inyong school. So, mo na ni musulod ang inyong program o gi-review. So, certified correct, pero gi-review. Pwedeng ang dean o program head or any faculty in charge na kailahang i-assign na mag-collect sa documents sa students sa program itself, no? And then, i-review sa inyong dean and program head. And then, again, recommending approval ang ano, and then approve by your chancellor. That's 15 days prior. So, meaning, ang inyong isubmit would be Annex A and Annex B na mga documents, no? Kaning comprehensive semestral term report is after na lang, no? And sa term, wala mo na yung problema, i-collect lang na inyo. So, gina-collect na namo and your institution para makuha ninyo itong mga, mag-gather ninyo itong mga comments, recommendations, and unsang nahitabo sa activity, unsang na-learn sa mga students, no? Mautong content actually sa Annex A for your later on, strategic planning, no? Or inyohang meetings later on para makita ninyo if effective na ang inyong activities na gipangbuhat. So, mao nang basis ninyo later on sa kanang naas sa Annex C. Okay, exempted. So, may na, again, naamoy, naay mga activities na required ang school na mag-submit og Annex A, B, og C. Pero not all, no? So, exempted ato will be the schools na granted autonomous and deregulated. So, we have UM, UIC, Ateneo, no? So, there are 7, no, sa ato ang region. And then, those programs na granted center of excellence or center of development, or at least level 2 accredited ang program, no? And then, para dire-diretso na mo, pwede na mo dili mag-submit, no? Sa CHED, no? So, SUCs with at least level 3, para ni sa mga public. Ah, sa inyo, come home, UP Mindanao, no? At least level 3 ang program. What are required to submit Annex A? No? Annex A is just a certificate of compliance lang na notarized. And then, non-curricular activities, and then yung mga field studies. Kaya, syempre, ubay-ubay ba ito, no? Murag, in one program, baka several days na. So, dili na kailangan na mag-submit og mga requirements sa CHED. Okay. So, student obligations, responsibilities, and obligations must be officially enrolled. So, dapat pang mag-submit mo og mao na gina-require na mo na ang list of students na mag-participate gikan yun sa registrar's office. Kasi og yun na mga tinuod na enrolled na mga students, no? Sila yun na maka-certify, ana. And then adhere to the rules and regulations of the student manual. So kung wala sa inyo student manual, unsa man ang inyo sundo, no, na guidelines. So submit a learning journal and or paper. So this is for your program, no, para mauning inyo ang pinaka na-learn dito, no? So dili itong mga exam, dili itong mga ano. So dili gyud siya pwede ikambyo. And then imposition of sanctions according with accordance with the HEI's policy. So mao ni siya, ma'am. So unsang ato ang mahatag na sanction karon pag dili mo submit, wala sa ato ang policy. So mao gito kailangan i-review ninyo ang inyong mga guidelines, no, inyong mga manuals. Okay, so CHEDRO will conduct a monitoring and evaluation of the compliance vis-a-vis obligations and liabilities of HEIs, the documentary requirements and activities undertaken. Okay, because again, not all activities ginasubmit sa CHED, but we want to make sure na ang school is really conducting yung merong mechanism in conducting the off-campus activities wherein naga-check sila og documents gihapon, no? Maski dili nyo gina-inform ang CHED, no, sa mga activities ninyo. And then excluded diha, exempted again. So mo ni mga privileges ng mga accredited and katong mga granted autonomous and deregulated. So dili kay sila hassle kay mga ano naman sila, no, naana sila sa above minimum requirements manggod na mga schools. Okay, so ako I am in charge of this, na kami ang naga-send og summary. So those documents inyong mga activities conducted gina record na namo, and we submit that for reporting sa CHED Central Office, specifically sa OSDS, Office of the Student and Student Development and Standards. Okay, so Section 16, this is important, no? Students should only be charged for actual costs of transportation, entrance fees, and related expenses subject to consultation. So dili shall sila basta-basta maningil without the prior consultation na i-conduct. Kailangan na amo dito, no? Attendance. Dapat naka-assign mo dito sa attendance. General information on fees related to the conduct of off-campus activities should be included in the student handbook or manual. So again, that's part of your policy dapat po. Okay? Very important ang student manual. Violations and sanctions. The following are considered violations of these policies and guidelines. You fail to comply with the policies and guidelines. So failure to comply with any of the requirements in CMO, such as conduct of orientation or consultation, conduct of activity without approval of the president, or in your case, the chancellor of the HEI. Verification with agency concerned on roadworthiness of vehicles, so such as LTO and LTFRB. Validation of appropriate license of the driver. Establishment of parallel activities. Submission of required reports to CHEDRO. Submission of requirements for required timelines. Or compliance with the requirements and obligations. No, so... Another is imposition of punitive measures upon the student who failed to attend or join the activity. So makabalumian na pag nai mag-complain. No? So if na-punish because or giyatagan og INC. No? Pero na kay valid reason pero giyatagan kag INC kay dili pwedeng dili mo ban. So you can always go to our office if dili mo. But as much as possible diri lang sa mo sa school, ha? You go to your OSA first. Pag dili pag yun, ato mo sa VP. Pag na-exhaust na tanan, no? Appeal ang security guard, ha? Dili pod, no? So appeal na tanan inyong admin. Tatan-tanan sa school sa ninyo kasi ang school has the policies and guidelines on how to handle those things, no? Saka na mawa sa amuan, no? Kung dili nagyud kanang murag desperate na mo, no? Ingana. So I think na may proper na mechanism ang inyong schools with regards to that. So kaya na ni ma'am, si ma'am na talaga ang bahala, no? Si Director Osa. Okay? Deployment of unqualified PIC. So unqualified, for example, wala talagang kanang from outside na talang qualified at pwede ninyo sila i-send for trainings. No? O send sa mga orientations. Yes, first aid training. Kasi may requirement na first aid kit. Tapos ang mag-uban sa inyo na in charge di kabalo mo gamit. So unsaon ninyo ang first aid kit. No? So kana siya. So one of the trainings na kailangan or dapat ang personal in charge should acquire is katong training sa first aid. No? So kay pag nay may tabo inside, no? Or asaba mo, no? At least siya ang pinaka first, gina-expect na tong pinaka first mag-respond sa mga ing ana. All other analogous circumstances. Okay, sanction. So, the CHEDRO after due process may impose the following appropriate sanctions depending on the nature and seriousness of the violation or non-compliance of the HEIs with the policies and guidelines stated in the CMO. Number one, ang pinaka-first, of course, written warning. And then the second one is cancellation of activity. And then, of course, yung order the refund of collected fees. So thereafter, CHEDROs are required to submit within 30 days to the CHED legal Muagi na mo ang legal ni, no? LLS, Legal and Legislative Service, actions taken in the pursuance of the provision. No? So for violations or non-compliance of the HEIs affecting the general public and or national interest, the Commission and Bank, taking into consideration the recommendation of the CHED LLS, the legal office, may impose the following sanctions depending on the nature and seriousness of the violation or non-compliance of HEIs. So ang first is ang blacklisting of the third party, kanang franchise or the tour agency ninyo, no, operator, pwede nato na i-blacklist. So dakong kawalan na sila ha pag ma-blacklist, no. Second is suspension from conducting off-campus activities for a period of time as determined by CEB. So dili ka conduct ang school na, no, depende kung pila ang ilahang ihatag na timeline. And then, ang repeated violations of this CMO may result to imposition of penalties such as revocation of permits, So ma-revoke ang permit, meaning dili nang pwede i-offer ang program. So gradually ipahinahinay na itong mga last na enrolled, dili na mo accept og another batch, no? So that's the last thing sana, no, na mahitabo sa isa ka school. Downgrading of status, or kung downgrading of status meaning level 2 ka, i-downgrade kag level 1, or tanggalon gyud ang imong level, no? Balik ka sa minimum requirements sa shed. And then phase out, and such other penalties may be validly imposed by the commission to the concerned HEIs. So this is without prejudice to the right of the concerned students or injured parties to file the necessary criminal or civil charges or administrative charges against the school and or its administrators under the civil code or other applicable laws. Okay, basig na apay lain complaints manggud to, no? Okay, so skip na nato ni siya. Okay, lifted na moratorium. Okay, so this is the Annex A, no? Mao ni ang pasabot namo na certificate of compliance. So ang pasabot ani na naay guidelines ang school, procedures sila sa pag-conduct ng activity. So gibuhat to nila tanan hantud sa pag-check sa documents. So certifying na gi-check na nila tanan, ready to go na ang mga estudyante. So meaning ang bola is naa sa school. Igo lang migi-inform sa school na ma'am, okay na po ang mga estudyante. We have already checked their documents. They are safe to go sa activity, no? So mo ni siyang certificate of compliance. So nadiha certified correct by the personnel in charge and then recommended by your VPP vice president and then approved by your chancellor. Tapos duly notarized, o mao gyud na siya, no? And then this is Annex B, mao ni akong pasabot na checklist.
Okay.
So pag mag-submit sa amo dapat check tanan. So kung is maski isa na no, dili na pwede i-submit sa amo, no? So dapat yes na tanan. Okay, so again, ang curriculum must be approved by CHED. Ang destination kailangan ma-specify ninyo na anay nakabutang sa taas. As you can see, nasa taas, unsa na program ang mag-travel, no? Unsa na mga estudyante, and then unsang subject, kung asa siya required, no? And then, asa ang destination, be specific on that, asa ang inyong venue, and then inclusive dates, number of students, and then the personnel in charge. So, mao nang pinaka-detail ninyo sa, na kailangan namo for our assessment. And then you need the handbook or manual na naa-add to ang inyong guidelines sa off-campus activities. So that's part of your requirement, no? And then medical certificates, consent of the notarized consent. Ibalik-balik ko yung nakabutang diya. Pero notarized consent na siya of duly notarized ng inyong parents' consent, personal in charge, first aid kit. So again, kailangan na ay training ang inyong personal in charge in first aid, okay? Naatay first aid kit. Okay, fees. The fees to be collected from students must be duly approved and disseminated to concerned stakeholders. So dapat, before mo magbayad, gi-inform sa mo na ingani. But for some educational tools, ha, kunwari, dako na, kanang mo atong Manila, mo atong Baguio, usually mo manang atuan, no? Dapat na ay muagi mo bidding. Dapat na ay katungod ang estudyante mamili kinsa ang gusto nila na agency. Okay, sometimes piliun nila ang pinakaubos na presyo, no? Kay kung dili ta muagi bidding, na ay mga schools na namong na encounter na diretso kani nya ang mga estudyante, uy mahal man eh. So dapat wala tay ingana, na dili mo react ang mga estudyante. So dapat mo agi og bidding and then it approved by, dapat sign sa mga estudyante. So para walay samok pagkahuman, no, na kani siya okay na ni sa amua, no, na price, no, sa ano. So dili dapat idiretso sa mga estudyante na oy kani nya, kani di ay nya. Kung i-compare ni mo sa other tour, travel and tours, mas ubos pa the same lang ang destination. So wala ni mo gihatagan og chance ang mga estudyante na mamili based sa ilang capacity lang, no? Okay, so kana siya, so kailangan na i-take notes sa ato ang mga faculty and students. Okay, so ang insurance, I think sa inyo ang enrollment, naana sa miscellaneous, ma'am, no? Insurance? Yes, ma'am. Kana po, importante. That's good, ma'am. Sige po. Ang mobility, again, yung kanina owned by HEIs, yung checking, licenses, permits, no? Kailangan to siya from our partner na mga agencies, no? Be sure lang na naay mga ingana. And then, ang coordination with LGU, so dapat na yung mga permit din yan, no? Permit or letter na nag-request kayo sa LGU for, or ingani, so informing the LGU, and then nag-reply back ang LGU. So those are documents na pwede nato i-attach, no? And then activities that, such as orientation sa students, again, balik-balik ni, consultation, announcements, briefing, learning journals, emergency preparedness, pag-post sa mga activities, I think si Ma'am Kabalo na ana, no? So basically, ginapost ng mga non-curricular activities sa ilang mga conspicuous places, no? Para inform lang ang ato ang stakeholders na mauning mga activities sa school. Okay? So this is Annex C. O mauno siya, no? Kailangan lang, sa mga problems, very important ni siya, no? Para ma-improve ang inyohang pag-conduct sa mga activities. Or maybe kailangan ilisa na niya ng activities kaya wala man siya ay gawa, no? So, magmugawas na siya sa Annex C na ihatag sa ato, sa inyohang mga programs. And then recommendations. So, for improvement, continuous improvement sa inyohang office, no? In particular, sa pag-conduct ng off-campus activities. So, katulang. So, maybe ang next ani will be the open forum. So thank you and good morning.
Thank you so much, ma'am. At this point, the floor is now open for any questions or clarifications regarding the topic that has just been discussed. Our guests from Zoom can type their questions in the chat box.
Engineer, hindi ba automatic ang personnel in charge ay yung faculty requesting the field trip?
Ang personnel in charge, ma'am, is depende po, ma'am, ha? Dapat kailangan talaga ang guidelines, no? So if kasi dapat designated. This. Ang in-charge is, pwede ninyo the activity kasi sometimes, hindi ang faculty mismo ang sumasama. So may mga ganyan na cases, manggod. So depende sa activity, sorry, hindi mismo. Pero for the activity na kanang para sa class mismo, talagang ang faculty yun siya, ma'am, no? Pero when it comes to sino ang mag-collect ng mga documents, sino po yan, no? So, sino ang ano? So, kailangan talaga yung policy ninyo, ma'am, i-stipulate ang accountability po. So, pero ang pinaka head sa lahat ng personnel in charge will be the OSA office. Yes. Oh, yes. So, kailangan talaga, ma'am, i-make it clear sa guidelines ninyo na yan ang ano. So, para ang accountability, ma'am. So, mag-facilitate, of course, ang sasama, ganito. Pero, ang nakalagay dun sa signatory, program head, tama yun, no? Review, program head. So, kailangan meron talagang clear na nakalagay dun ano ang responsibility ng each personnel na sasama, sino ang magre-receive ng documents, sino mag-approve ng activity. So, para klaro po. So, yun, ma'am.
So, kasi in our case, nangyari na ba na yung faculty in charge mismo hindi kasama sa field trip. Hindi, no. It's actually the faculty in charge who makes, collects all the document. Okay? So, yung personnel in charge, hindi siya yung, I take it to mean na yung faculty teaching the course that has that field trip is the personnel in charge. But in your case, you are recognizing that the personnel in charge should be someone above than the faculty in charge. Program head. So siya yung... Oo.
Constant na, pinaka-consistent na.
Oo.
Kasi para monitoring mo naman sa mga activities, no? Kahit pa iba-iba po ang sumasama na sa activities.
Hindi ko ba siya pwede na yung monitoring is per course?
Pwede yan. Depende po sa design ninyo, ma'am, ng inyong ano. Yes, ma'am. Para ano talaga, malas ang inyong, ang concern ko kasi sa office ninyo, baka ma-overload kasi ang inyo, overloaded kayo ng mga, kasi lahat ng activities. So, para malasin kayo, yung mga some of your tasks na ginagawa na pwede naman ang department na lang, supervised by the program head or the dean, edi sa kanila na lang. And then, sa inyo na lang is yung pinaka, ano na, karang accumulated na ng mga documents o reports na lang.
Actually, for some time I have been wondering why field trips, educational field trips, go to our office. Kasi parang ang idea ko is all academic starts with the faculty, department chair, the dean, then vice chancellor. Kasi hindi dumadaan sa student affairs ang curricular activities. Okay? So, for field trips, dumadaan siya sa amin. It's because we issue the certificate of insurance coverage. Yun. Kaya sabi ko parang ang weird note, kung dadaan sa OSA, kasi hindi naman kami part ng arrangement ng curriculum, ng basta pag curricular, may linyan din to the vice chancellor. Pero pag non-curricular, like student activities, yung organization, the advisor, then OSA. So yun yung iniisip namin na yun yung direction. Pwedeng personnel in charge yung OSA kasi OSA needs to ensure na kumpleto yung documents ng organization before they go out. But for curricular activities, parang hindi kasama ang OSA dito sa amin eh. And checklist, siguro, we can actually determine kung kompleto o hindi. Balik namin sa inyo. Wow, galing. Hindi kayo pwede lumabas. Ibalik namin sa inyo kung hindi kompleto yan bago umakyat sa Vice Chancellor. Pwedeng ganon. Kasi for student activities, meaning organizations, it ends with OSA. Usually, pinapaalam kay Chancellor pag may request na iba, no? Okay? So, from the OSA, Chancellor na kagad. Okay? Pero, ang field trip, faculty, dean, vice chancellor, dumadaan ng OSA because of the insurance, and then vice chancellor before the chancellor. Okay? So, parang parang ang weird na ang faculty in charge even for curricular activities OSA pa rin. When the program Now, walang ano ang also with the how the program is being run. So, kung tama nga. Oo, so program head siguro yung personnel in charge. Yes.
Sa policy na gagawin ng university. Unlike other SUCs that OSA is really in charge of everything, no? Kasi sa amin parang VCAA yung ibang yung curriculum and then for the non-curriculum it's OSA. Allowed po ba yun sa CHED, ma'am? Na ilagay siya sa aming manual in case we make
may mga CMO na related ng mga orientations. Ang OSA talaga ang sinisend. So, thinking na ka ng ang mga activities na such as that, no, of off-campus activities. But again, ma'am, may academic freedom ang school. So, if it's not stipulated sa CMO, kasi walang specific doon na OSA eh. Pero pag sinabing student affairs kasi, ang tinatawag mga OSA. So, murag in general. But, again, na academic freedom, pareho niyan, i-design ninyo ma'am, kasi ang nakalagay lang doon, pero very specific lang, program in charge, mag-sign, ang dean, program med, mag-sign, ang VPAA, kanay. Yan lang ang specific doon. So when it comes to how you do it na sa procedures, ang importante nasa institutional policy. So yun po, ang hinahanap natin, kaya nga kung ano, pag nasa manual, ikaw, ma'am, hindi ikaw, oh, sige. So, yun nandun sa manual. So, mas maganda yung naka-in place na talaga yung handbook, ma'am, or yung operations manual niyo in terms, in specific sa inyong off-campus activities para klaro siya. Pero, yung nandun sa minimum requirements naman sa CMO, such as VPAA, nakalagay talaga VPAA, hindi OSA, wala naman nakalagay OSA talaga, ma'am. Tama, ma'am, punto siya. No? So, dito ninyo siya ma butangan og specifics na gyud. So tama man pud ang inyo hang ano ma'am. Pero in general man good giniingon OSA. Pero sige lang ma'am, kamo na bahala institution na ninyo, mag-design na lang mo kung saon ninyo siya.
Ba to nag-share. Wala wa tang extra ano, microphone. Anyway, thank you po. Ang nakalagay doon personnel in charge lang eh. So in our case we can discuss that with the ano sa execom level siguro kung ano ang responsibilities na bawat pupuntahan, pero yun nga kasi separate man good talaga yung curricular, kasi curricular it's the department that has the authority over how they conduct their activities. Okay, so outside the curriculum, OSA na siya. Yun yung understanding ko. Kaya mapag-usapan namin ulit kung paano siya ginagawa dito. But because meron rin kasing arrangement ng UP. Kasi we do have a chancellor here. But our programs in terms of curriculum is also aligned with that of the system. So we have the president and meron kami BOR, Board of Regents, ang chair ng CHED, ang chairman ng Board of Regents namin. So actually, we get our directive from them. Tapos how we implement our programs, galing din doon. Okay, so kung in the other CUs, constituent universities like UP Diliman, UP Manila, it resides with the Vice Chancellor for Academic Affairs. Sa Academic Affairs talaga siya. Okay, well, yung mga Office of Student Affairs naman rin, iba-iba rin yung hinahawakan rin eh. Pero yun nga, there are certain policies regarding curricular requirements. And usually it's the one in charge, the department, the program, who dictates ano yung dapat doon sa program na yon. Okay? So we now recognize that the personnel in charge should be cleared with us. So thank you for that para mapag-usapan namin. So for me, It's clear if non-curricular siya, OSA kagad. Pero pag curricular, ibigay niyo pa rin ba sa OSA or for the program itself? Kasi iba ang curricular arrangement. Kumbaga, walang hawak ang OSA dun sa curriculum.
Walang centralized at least the boards para mayroon tayong list of activities, curricular, both curricular and activities. Paano po? Yun po ang measure i-consider natin.
Yun ang kanya-kanya actually monitoring by sector din. Oo. Oo. So, meron kami ngayon ginagawa strategic planning, tapos nagsasubmit doon ng accomplishment report lahat. Pero who keeps the records? Kung field trip ni faculty, pag ni-approve ni chancellor, babalik sa kanya lahat. Siya ang mag-keep. And sa inyo, the office of the dean keeps a copy. Yes, yun po. Bumabalik sa department yung approved letter with all the attachments. So it's the department that...
Say, pag-monitor, tingnan namin. So, kasi verbal lang, ma'am, yun ang hindi clear.
So baka pinapractice lang siya, but it's not really the part sa inyong policy na yun. So baka yung ibang department ibang ginagawa because wala talagang hindi sila guided ano talaga ang dapat gawin ng each department for that. So yun lang ma'am, yun para klaro lang sa lahat, no? So practice lang siguro siya, pero actually it's really not the policy of the school. Yes ma'am. Yes ma'am.
Actually, sa akin, kayo ang magpapa-field trip lahat ng cardinal.
Yes, ma'am. Especially yung mga documents na necessary kasi yan ang natin proof na safe ang ating activity. So very crucial na dapat merong accountable person talaga na kailangan nakalagay talaga sa inyong policy, ma'am.
Meron kaming tinatawag na travel order. Andun nakalagay, you are authorized to go to this place, ganyan. Ang tawag dyan, office order for the civil service. Yan yata yung designation. Can that be part of designation? Kasi may nakalagay doon, travel order, you are hereby authorized to go to for this, ganyan, ganyan. Tapos sa baba, andun yung itinerary of travel. So, does that constitute the designation of the person?
Parang lahat yata tayo sa government may ganyan, ma'am. Kasi pati kami, you are allowed to go out. Pero not necessarily na yung ikaw ang accountable sa mga estudyante na dala-dala mo. So I think mas better yung separate, ma'am, na document na saying that you are in charge of this and then mga list of students. Sa government, required talaga yan sa civil service. Eh. So not necessarily saying na you are accountable. So kung simali ba nila doon sa inyong nakalagay na travel something na magdadala ka ng estudyante, no? So iba rin yun sa na case, ma'am. So dapat designation talaga or you are really the faculty in charge of that specific na activity. Para sure na lang yun, ma'am. Para safe na lang yun ang mga bata.
So please take note, kailangan natin ng designation as responsible for the off-campus local activity. Hindi lang yung travel order. Kasi yung travel order will inform anyone who sees it, you are on official business. But the designation of the person na sinasabi ni ma'am must indicate there that you are responsible for all the undertakings of that off-campus activity. So for... in our case, it's usually the faculty in charge. For student activities, it's the faculty advisor. Okay.
There is the lack of proper talaga na policy with regards dito sa paano yung pamamalakad ng off-campus activities within the university. Tapos na-mention niya rin, ma'am, na mag-craft sa execom level. Pero for the side naman kasi ng students, hindi naman kasi parte ang students ng execom. So we need to ensure na when crafting these policies, kasi meron talagang student representation I don't know who can answer this kasi nakalagay doon kanina yung mga exceptions. Tapos when it comes to the state universities, level 3, di ba? Is UP Min, what level po ba is UP Min? Like, who can answer that? Kabalo, kabal. Sa level.
Ang level yata dyan is yung ano, yung institution, tertiary, level 3. Sa suks tayo. Level 3. Kasi meron tayong graduate programs and we have research. You become level 3 if you have 3 programs: teaching, research, and extension, yun. And you have graduate program, okay? Actually, kung hospital yan, bed capacity ang level, di ba? Tapos...
Check ko yung level ng UP Mindanao sa aming
graduate. Ay, ganun. Iba pa ang UP Diliman sa UP Mindanao. Constituent University kami. Meaning, it's the same but it's only in another place. Offering other courses. Pero yun na nga yung isa pang ano doon is CHED approved. We are not aware if BOR sends it to CHED pa for approval. Ang chairman nyo sits on the BOR. So does it follow that whatever we teach here is CHED approved also?
Level.
I double check na. Pero if ano kayo, satellite campus kayo, ma'am. Ano kayo attached kay sa main? So kung ano yung level ng main yun po? Na ano kayo, constituent? Sige, double check. Kasi ang autonomous na term sa private HCIs lang kasi yan, but you are public kasi kayo. Baka internal lang ninyo na term yan, ma'am. Internal. Kasi dyan. Sige lang. SUCs eh. UP. Sige lang, ma'am. I-clarify natin yan. So, yun na natin.
Actually, para kay Ma'am Kuan, kay Ma'am Stella, since we are sa UP system, ma'am, meron na bang mga guidelines ang other CUs regarding the field trips in reference to the CMO? Kasi baka pwede ganun or meron, di ba?
Actually, yung kasi I asked our legal officer for the parent consent form na pwedeng ibigay. Tapos kung pwedeng, well, we will notarize because that is the policy. We will notarize it. But I got from the orientation na pwede siyang gawing semestral. Gawin siyang semestral kasi isusulat mo yung mga subjects mo and organizations you are joining there na pinapayagan ng parent na sumama siya for all, any of campus of activities of these subjects and organizations. Kaya nga semestral. Kasi hindi siya pwedeng yearly kasi iba naman yung kukunin mo the following the following sem, hindi mo alam. So at the start of the semester and actually in dilim halos ganun yung tono ng parent consent form sa Diliman. I don't know kung notarized nila, but it's the policy that says that it has to be notarized. Okay? And yun na nga, ginaklaro ko kasi noon, kahit gaano kaganda yung parent consent and waiver, that does not relieve the person in charge, hindi na person in charge, the faculty of responsibility. Kasi it only says kung finalaw lahat ng procedures and it has not the university and the faculty in charge had not been negligent, then wala siyang pananagutan if na accident yung group. Okay, but that does not help if it is proven na yung accident is due to negligence. So one of that would be not following the policy. If you did not follow the policy, then you were negligent in your responsibility. Parang ganun yun. Then meron kang responsibility in terms of kung ano yung mangyari doon sa student. But if you followed everything and well, accidents do happen and the accidents still happen, you are not responsible for yung any cause that will arise from the accident. Yun lang naman nakalagay doon. Pero notarized daw.
Ano daw yun? Dela si Ma'am. So yun po, basta sa policy namin Ma'am, kailangan talaga notarize. Pero ang pagcraft ninyo dito sa inyuhang, wala kaming template sa ano talaga ang content doon. So it will depend, tama yun siya. Tinanong pa ka pwedeng ma-benchmark ngayon para sa yung sa inyong main or ano yung effective na sa kanila na sistema in off campus. Baka pwede ninyo i-benchmark na or meron na sila and so in the context sa inyuhang school, no, so kung anong pwede ninyo matweak gamay na pwedeng magikan sa kung na-notice ninyo may annex C doon, recommendation, mga problems arise. So yun siya, pag i-accumulate yun, pwede natin magigital consensus na para maiwasan to siya ng mga issues, no. So yun siya ma'am, so sa school na namin yan sa ginahatag ng mga diskresyon, no, na unsaon ninyo ang inyong mga templates, unsaon ninyo pag implement sa inyong ano, but ang pinaka sure gud namo dapat is dapat naka-in-place ang inyong policy. So yun nga, as you've said, pag hindi i-follow ang policy, ito siya is guidance ng CHED. This is a policy of CHED. Pero kailangan naka-stipulate yun na sa inyong institutional policies, ma'am. No, kaya na yung mga areas dito na possible, pwede mo magdagdag, no? And then ang mga, dili man kani ang ato ang ginahatag sa students, but that student manual man. So it has to be there, no? So kailangan yun ang gina-follow. So namang po mo yung system, as you've said, ang UP na ay system na ano, and then you are following the same system. So kailangan naka-incorporate doon both, no? Both kay na ay gina-mention dito, depende unsang mission sa school. So plus the policy of CHED na minimum. So dapat ang minimum manggod ni siya. So plus na tong inyo. So dapat kato siya is clear sa inyuhang mga manuals, no? So kato lang ma'am, kalang naalang gid sila i-follow na para consistent tanan faculty students they are following it, pati ang templates kailangan klaro, no? So mao gyud ning approved template, So kung sa ISO pa na nay number ng inyong template, maugi ni ang pinaka-standard na template na kailangan gamitin sa mga bata. Dili sila magkanya-kanya. No, sa katulang yun, ma'am. So standard sa tanan, sa mechanisms, sa mga checklists, sa tanan-tanan, following the minimum requirements of CHED. So katulang po.
Kasi di ba na-mention na dapat ilagay sa...
Na dapat ilagay sa parents' consent yung mga list of activities for that semester. Pero how about those activities na are invitation basis? Like for example, the sports tournaments na less than a month before the event lang yung invitation na masesend. Tapos base doon sa need gawin before, during, and after, it would take at least a month. So what's the mechanism in place po with regards to that? Do we create our own or... So with regards po dun sa, to reiterate, with regards po dun sa parents' consent na notarized, okay lang po na general na activity theme. Like for example, sports event. Ganun lang.
Okay, do you think kung general kayo ng term? Kasi sa amin ha, we are just making sure na safe ang mga estudyante. Now, kamo, kasi para to make it easier for you, lagyanin ng general. So, walang specific event dyan ngayon. So, what if merong event na lagay-lagay kayo dyan and then it matters kung ano yan siya na specific. Do you think ang CHED ang magano? So, ang CHED actually ang mag-ano sa school, bakit ganun? So, might as well, you may make it clear na lang kung ano yung mga activities na hindi siya annually kinoconduct or hindi talaga siya planned na activities, invitational siya. So it has to be stipulated sa inyong policy. Anong gagawin niyo pag ganyan? So at least you made it easier na sa inyo na part na majority of your activities in the whole SEM kasa na lang mo nagparental consent. Yung mga ginagmay na lang ng mga invitational, yun na lang ang at least lesser lang. So, hindi wala ta, nag-comply ta sa CHED, pero at the same time, easier on that part yung sa documentation na hindi siya pa isa-isa na siya ng activities. So, if you think na yung pag-general term sa inyong activities, na hindi nyo dinidefine ano yung specific na activities, if it's safe na ganun, it's up to the school, ma'am. No, it's up to the school, no? So basta just always think kung safe ba ang bata if ing ato. So wala problema if in general wala man ay problema.
Actually, ma'am, yung mga instant marami man yan eh. Like hindi tatawagin ka sa sanggunian, magdala ka ng 5 estudyante para mapag-usapan ito. Minsan 3 days lang before the activity doon ka bibigyan. So paano mo pa mapapahabol ang parent consent? And magpe-parent consent ba si Kobe botante na? And
actually na-raise yan siya ng question sa orientation is 2017. So ang CHED stands sa
parents consent pa rin na notarized kasi nakaano na eh, no? Notarized talaga siya. I do not know sa next na revision if ma-consider ba siya na mawala. Pero na-approve na kasi siya na CMO. Oo. Oo. O pwede naman, hindi naman siya necessary na parent. Kung for example, may asawa ka na, pwede ang wife or husband. Yes po.
Yes.
Yan. Yeah. Yes. Legal age na kasi. Oh. Yes, I understand. Oh. Correct. Yes.
Yeah. Pero sa legal age. Of legal age, yeah. Na-raise yan siya. Correct. Oo, pag dili hatag ang consent. Mas strict ang fence. Yes.
Another concern din kasi ma'am, dito sa ating school, hindi mo from one place lang lahat.
Correct.
From Luzon, from Palawan. So paano nila makukuha? Kailangan
ba
authorize kayo, mag-appear at the same time, wet signature.
Yes, correct. Sige lang, ma'am censors. I understand your sentiments. I agree actually, no? Kasi basta legal age ka na, so pwede na maka-decide. ayaw po. Oo. So you can include that, ma'am, sa inyo ang policy, no? So minimum, this is minimum, no? So if mo take og risk ang school, they can add sa ilang policy ang mga ganyan, mga dili exempting the minimum requirement of CHED, but yung adding some considerations also dito, no, kanang medyo kana kung gi kanong consultations, these are good inputs, ma'am, no, so pwede nato siya i-gather. So i-marry lang nato sa CHED minimum requirements. So kana siya yung sa vehicle, ha, sa transportation, medyo ano to kasi, yeah, yes, so kailangan nagi consultation na sa nanay, consultation sa students when it comes sa mga fees. So kailangan mo agi ng mga ano, no. Pero yung ano lang, ha, yung mga rental lang. So yun, there are things na ang school ang talagang in search on. Oh. Kanas. Ay, kaya isa na lang na ninyo, no? So, oh my God. I-silent lang siguro yan. So, pwede na siya buhat. Pero, i-silent lang. But, you have to ask permission sa inyohang mga personal in charge para inform sila, no? Inform kay sila ra ba ang responsible, no? So, kana, of course, automatic na mga ingana ng mga butang. So, peka to, just be safe lang na kung magdalag, oo. Basta, i-allow sa inyohang school naa sa inyong policy, walay problema na siya, no? So basta with the consent of your school. So usually ang ilahang ginahatag na consent is sa ilahang mga spouses. Auntie. Kaya dinigig ko mo ingon na walay parental consent kay basig mano taga-chedway ako, no? So pero tanawon lang unsang inyuhang kung i-allow kasi sila nagadawat og ano, no, dahil sila nagadawat og documents, no. So basta it has to have a consent from a guardian or from a parent, no, so para safe. Oh, guardian.
Yeah.
No, our minimum should be in the guidelines,
plus your institutional na mga policies. So, dapat follow yun. So, yun ang minimum. So, meaning yun ang i-follow first. And then you can add. Innovate mo, mag-innovate. Pero na-added to dapat ang minimum requirements sa CHED. Yes, ma'am.
Sabihin sa quality program na ang Philippines program. So it's a 5-unit course for third year BS Atco students na nag-stay sila sa ano, nag-stay sila sa community for 1 month. So is it are we accepted?
I think that's under the field study and experiential kasi part mang kaya gid siya sa ano sa so hindi siya yung visit og mga di ba so mao gyud to siya ang dapat ginabuhat sa klase and then in a place outside of your school, so that's part of experiential and field study na area which is exempted sa pag isubmit sa CHED. But sa school dapat naamoy mga documents sa school. So kanang non-curricular and field study, experiential study dapat sa school na siya, sa institution ginasubmit. So depende sa policy ninyo. So ang nakabutang dito is pwede ninyo i-follow to sa CMO 16, CMO 63 ma'am na checklist or pwede mo mag-ano. Pero katong mga i-submit sa CHED katong yun to, no checklist. It's not considered internship, ma'am. Oo, kanang mura siya, klase siya. O klase, mawag yun itong mga specific na mga activities na ginabuhat nila sa klase. Outside lang siya sa school. So meaning, you have to submit based sa CMO 104. Kung considered siya practical, make sure lang ano ba talaga. Kung OJT siya kung hindi siya OJT. Yes, so if dili siya considered or counted sa inyong prospectus na OJT, so it might be considered field study. Pero if nakabutang dito practicum na, internship na, So ang name sa i-base na siya sa PSG sa program, no? So internship or OJT ba na siya na pangalan, no? Sa kung kana na siya na subject, so it's considered internship na dapat ang gina-follow si MO 104. But if it's a separate na subject na activity gina siya, that's a field study or an experiential. Yeah, experiential. So i-sure lang ha na dili na siya internship kasi lahi na siya na si MO Manggod. Yes. Yeah. So school na magki-cater ana ma'am. No, sige lang mag-handle ana. Oo. Oo, curricular siya. Yes, ma'am. Yeah.
In relation sa question ni ma'am, sa context but I think sa BSAB and many other programs, final requirement for graduation is yung undergraduate thesis. And then these students have to complete their thesis individually, although they are assigned to advisors. And then depending on what they proposed, it would or it could require them to gather data wherever they may have, whichever area they may have selected. Tapos ang challenge doon, ma'am, kay paano yung, how do we treat that? Siguro, is it under a field study? Ang challenge is, the faculty in charge cannot accompany each student sa kanyang data gathering activities. And also, yung mga transport arrangements, hindi ba niyo ma-formalize, ma'am? Saan na to? Silent ako. Gatong mga ingan, ma'am. So, how do we treat that? Thank you po.
Di ba included man na sa details sa inyong thesis? Kana mga budget requirements, including ang mga travels ninyo? Naman na sa parang gina-declare na sa inyo ang mga documentation? Wala ba, ma'am?
Yung sa budget, siguro is not really included yung everyday gastos to go there, pero yung gastos mo when you're there. Like,
mm.
Kung mag-interview ka, yung snacks,
mm.
yung token, yun lang yun, it's not bad. Pero yung pagpapunta, usually yung pinag-check in your hotel. Hindi ko pwede mo siya ma-estimate na,
yeah.
My thesis kay kasampo lang ako pa doon.
Yeah.
Possible, it's different but material conditions na nakakagin.
So, ma-answer na siya sa policy na i-craft sa school. Kasi ang data gathering is part of the field study, experiential study. So, yun siya ma'am, is na dito sa definition na ang mag-observe, mag-gather of data for research. But, on how you will implement that, kay kato siya, nag-vary manggod ang situation. So, it has to be, ano ma'am, part sa inyong policy. Kay para, kung naglahi-lahi man ang inyong mga departments, at least if you have the policy na standard, ma-change na siya ma'am, it will be followed by all, na dili na maglahi-lahi. So, kana siya para ang mga estudyante medyo monitored po if nasobra na or nakulang na or unsa bang ilang ano. Including the fees, I think that's very important na kanang ginastoryahan, gina-declare nila ma'am ang ilang mga fees na ginagastos, no? Pwedeng outside na sa ilahang ginasubmit na. Pero nakasubmit manggugo ganun na. Ginahatag ang mga budget kung unsang inyo. Murag propose ninyo na. Or activity designs, no? Activity designs that you can submit kay na-add to ang budget. No? Para basig pwede mo maka-come up with that. So, additional mechanisms lang, ma'am. Para ma-declare ang mga budget sa mga bata. And then, ang mga days, kung kanusa lang sila pwede mag-ana-ana. Ano? So, i-klaro na lang, pwede na siya sa department na mga ano ninyo ma'am, consultation with the department kay para na ay mga inputs from them kay basig maglahi-lahi po sila, no? Maunang ano, so depende man gud sa kurso na, kani pareho din sa anthropology, lahi ni sila, kato sila, lahi sila. Pero it has to have a standard na policy ma'am, kay para dili, para ma-answer ang question sa inyo ang estudyante, no? Currently, it's included sa field study ang data gathering.
Student consultation. In most of the activities, mga field trip students.
Nasa CMO. Yes. Yes, ma'am. Appeal gyud na siya. Orientation or consultation. That's really part. Minimum siya. Minimum. Kasi dapat dili ang faculty ang mag-decide kinsa ang travel and tours, dili sila dapat. Ang estudyante na siya dapat moagay gyud na siya og mga bidding presentation, mag-compete na sila, pinaka-ubos. So, na.
Sa klase ka, maalis
eh. Pero, nagi ano ma'am, i-consult gyud ang mga estudyante. Siguro, kung walay mo agi bidding, pero dapat i-consult gyud ang mga estudyante if they agree. Yes. Nagi na i-proof sa meeting and then signed by the students na present. Pero, kana siya dapat ginapresent na sa ilaha, unsa na na-breakdown ng 8,000. So, para asa ni. So, nakabutang dito, dapat ang ilaha lang dapat bayaran, transportation. Unsa pa tong mga dapat gastuson. So dapat clear sa mga estudyante unsa na siyang 8,000, no? So para ano gyud. Kasi it's prone to complaints. Pag naay complaints mo respond gyud mi ana. So if magtan-aw mi sa CMO, that's really a violation na dili mag-consult. Tama ma'am.
Ng mga activities ng mga organizations. Kasi dito po sa amin, pwede lang legally mag-conduct.
So meaning illegal lang.
Pwede siya mag-conduct.
Yes, o.
Pag stipulation sa CHED na dapat, in order to be recognized, kasi dapat may mga forms na notarized, like from the organizations. Kasi during the pandemic, kung, or like nung, after the pandemic, like that year, the political attack, kasi yung pag, okay lang na hindi siya authorized, but recently, binalik na naman yung before the pandemic na need authorized yung...
Which is nasa policy ng school.
So,
that's a school policy, you have to follow that.
So, with that, pwede po siya ibahin. Kasi wala siya nakasipilit sa CHED na kailangan notarize yun.
But CHED will recognize institutional policy because they have academic freedom. Oo. Yes! Oo. Every minimum. Yes. Dapat iagi mag-ano man na, mag-consultation man ang school for revision. So, now, tam.
Ang sinasabi niya dyan, fraternities and sororities. Oo. Yung last time kasi ang ni-require namin ang fraternities and sororities. Oo.
Pero asan yan siya na parang sa student handbook?
Sa student handbook namin, oo.
Kung mag-revise na sila, ma, yan ang
So basta na sa student handbook, yun ang pinaka-ano diha, nga nung kailangan na as a student handbook kasi naagid may balikan if ever. So some more questions?
Good morning, ma'am. Magpala lang ko aside dun sa mga parents' consent and waiver. Yung naman ko sa checklist, yung medical clearance, actually na ay pending po sa mo ang ano karon na office na kailangan pa yung medical clearance. Pero sa checklist, medical clearance, if appropriate, signed by the ano HEI or government doctor. Pero wala mang good may ano, physician diri, ma'am. Ano, negotiable ba na siya na pwede, hindi kasi siya pwede maging semestral kasi yung schedule ng trips, hindi man ma-assess mo na ano, months before. So, parang the closest reasonable time na mag-check sila. So, ano ba yun? Pwede ba yun na i-assess ng nurse? Or is it kanang kailangan na sign talaga? Clearance or hindi kasi siya ma-medical certificate ang nakalagay. So, pwede ba yun na blanket clearance like ng insurance na covered sila? Paano po yun? Kasi po, every time na babiyahe, yun, mabayad din sila sa doctor kung ano po. Oo. Kasi usually, ma'am, yung mga field trip early na siya. So yung assessment, I mean, kung yung physically, sila, generally, physically, meron man sila kasing ano ganyan, ma'am, medical check-up upon yung sa enrollment, admission, ganun. But yung kanang biyahe, ma'am, na maaga, walang kain, yung mga ganun, yung may mga, ano, like asthmatic, mga ganun po. Yung physical nga po na ma-check, pwede po ba yun yung nurse like 2 days before or a day before? But, kasi po, hindi namin, kasi kung mag-follow lang po talaga kami sa, ano, hindi rin namin ma-forward for sa Office of the Chancellor, kung hindi rin complete. Tapos yun din ang dilemma nila. Hindi nila ma-comply kasi hindi agad ma-complete ng buong klase. Hindi lahat maka... Like ngayon, wala po talaga. Pwede po ba yun sa... Yun nga po ang tanong natin. Oo. Oo. So ano po yung
Oo. So dapat talaga physician. Kaya bakit po wala tayong physician, ma'am? Required yan minimum. Maski ano, yung outsourced or yung ano lang. Oo. Pwede naman siya, ma'am. Yung parang scheduled siya. Pero if yung mga ganyan dapat part sa inyong arrangement sa kanila, if merong mga ganyan na activities, dapat part yun ng ginagawa niya ng mga task. Oo.
Pero,
Pero siguro ma'am, baka pwede ninyo siya i-add sa kanilang mga contracts na i-add sa kanilang ano yan, mga task. Kasi ano yan eh, policy ng CHED. So maybe mabigyan ng ano ng school ninyo na because requirement po siya, so dapat ang physician dagdagan natin ng ano ng addition, may additional sa na task which is specific sa mga ano sa off campus. Walang nakalagay na ano ma'am, but dapat meron kayong physician sa school na licensed na ano. So it's either mag-top kayo ng ano, but meron talagang regular na nagko-conduct ng check-ups dito based sa inyong ano ma'am, ano yung mga activities ninyo sa mga students sa medical na aspect. So yan siya, maybe you have to add that. Yan para sa off campus, yan sa mga medical clearance para hindi na sila mag ano sa gawas, no? So ganyan lang ma'am, arrangement. Kasi hindi naman siya practical na ang physician nandito, no? So meron lang talaga yung scheduling ma'am, meron lang talaga yung scheduling. Pero ano talaga siya, may contract talaga siya sa school na kailangan, and na siya ang official na physician sa school. Not necessarily na dyan siya magstay. Not like the nurse, kailangan ang nurse talagang nasa school yan. Ang physician, and then yung concern ni ma'am na dapat ang mag-sign, yun ma'am, kailangan i-coordinate yun sa DOH. Kasi hindi ko yan ma-answer, no? Hindi ko yan ma-answer, but I think that's not a practice of a nurse na mag-sign in behalf sa isa ka physician, especially kay ma'am, what ano license sa physician? Or ang nurse ba mismo, no? So, i-clarify lang nato na siya ma'am, if allowed na siya or dili. I'm not saying na dili, but let's clarify na lang dito sa medical discipline.
Pagdating po sa pag-notarize, like let's say what if merong notary lawyer within the institution, okay lang ba na sila yun?
Oh, basta we are authorized to do that. No, walang problema. Yun ang maganda kasi. Dapat sa school para hindi na kayo lumalabas. And then there are, kung meron sa labas, baka pwedeng, hindi yata ya pwede. Yan siya. Meron yan siya. Baka maka-discount kayo kasi estudyante kayo, student discount sa notarization. Uy, 950 pesos. Sanggunian. Gani na sa ag, gani ko ma'am, no? Ganihan. No, kulay mo din yung yupimin. No, tama, oh. Oo. Yes. Ma'am, yun na po ang concern. Ang makakasolve will be kailangan i-request yan ni ma'am. That is a concern na valid, very valid na siya ma'am. I understand the students. Baka pwede ninyo i-request na meron kayong somebody na sa law office na pwedeng mag-notarize dito na within the school. Oo. Or somebody from your school mag-collect ma'am, then sila na bahala mag-facilitate or something. Oh, pero sana within the school ko mo ano, request na ma'am. Kawawa sila, actually layo ng school niyo ma'am.
So we have to go to downtown pa, magbayad 350 something like that.
For a low price naman ma'am, estudyante na price, baka pwedeng na ay mga lawyers na would cater that na total daghan magkaayo, no? So oo, baka pwede ma'am.
Request for
wow.
They
Baka pwede kayo magano ma'am, mag-establish ng partnership with that, no? Yes. Pwede yan erase. That's really a valid na ano, ma'am. I think ano lang naman yan siya, ma'am. Kung meron kayong, kasi minimum requirement ng physician, ma'am, ha, sa CHED, minimum requirement na siya. So, yung third party ninyo na i-hire na physician na meron lang schedule, maybe i-add lang sa iyahang contract ang medical cert clearance sa mga bata for the off-campus activities. So yun lang naman yan, sa contract lang naman yan, ma'am. No, mauning ang mga certain na mga requirements sa schools na kailangan na i-conduct ni mo. So para lang dili na maglisod. Sa lawyers, basi pwede na amoy ma-partner na lawyer? Na not necessarily na i-diri sa school, pero murag partners, pwede ba na IMOA or MOU or something na pag na minimal amount para sa mga estudyante for notarial kasi merong ginto. Ano nila? Or pro bono. Pro bono. Meron mga ganyan, ma. Mga ano na pwedeng magbuwatan na for students. Academic and... Yes. Oo. Yes. Yeah. So pwede na siya ano ma'am, ipasali sila sa mga one of your meetings with the students na parang consultations ninyo, i-appeal sila. Yes, sir. Yes, yes po. Pwede naman ma'am. Meron tabing ano in charge sa office sa student services. So pwede. So pwede rin natin siya i-request siguro sa central office kung gusto pa ninyo, no? Better if nasa taas. So pwede naman sir, i-written lang ninyo. So I'm not sure kasi hindi pa naman kami nakakontakt ng ganyan. So usually kasi academic freedom 'yan eh. So seldom lang ang school na nagre-request na ganyan. Pero you can do that, sir. You can do that. Yes.
So, is it correct ba na assume na since sa ngayon, hindi pa siya talaga nakalagay doon, wala pang hindi pa kami announce kumanta?
Supposedly kasi wala kayong oo. So pero si ma'am na mention niya kanina merong mga memos, siguro may mga memos for now, pero ma'am alangan man forever kayo magbuhat-buhat og mga memo. No, so required talaga ang student handbook, nandoon ang policy ng off-campus activities. That's actually part. Minimum actually na siya, no? So dili lang na siya sa CMO 63. Na siya dito sa pinaka-basic pagyod na student services na policy, yung sa CMO 9 series of 2013 na pa na dito, no? So if mayroong mga dapat ikanda, kailangan na sa inyong student handbook. Yes, ma'am.
As
I've said, minimum lang yan siya. So again, ang school has its academic freedom na mag-innovate, mag-add, mag-ano. So sige ma'am, kasi ang ano kasi it covers all the schools kasi in CMO. So hindi ko masyadong ma-answer if totally kanang you have your own na sistema. So I'll have to direct that to our director if ever, but definitely ma'am, ang masasabi ko lang ang sa CHED Manggod is minimum requirement. So it doesn't necessarily na kana lang ang inyo ang i-follow. So maybe
you can add, no? You can add and innovate from that. So, yun po. I'll just get back to that, ha? Yang sa mga public schools. But from what I know, no? So I've handled this for 8 years, included po ang public schools in the minimum requirements sa CHED. So I think they're aware of that naman siguro po, ma'am. Kasi part of the, di ba, member ng ano is the CHED. So, oo, aware naman sila. Oh, aware naman sila. Yes, ma'am. Oo. So aware yan sila, ma'am. Aware yan sila. Yes, ma'am. Yes. So I'm sure aware na siya sa policy, ma'am. Oo. Ah, may question. Abi na akong glass to.
Hi, good morning, ma'am. Rogessa Lopez po of School of Management. So I just don't know if this was asked earlier. Sorry for her. Pero nasa Zoom po ako kanina. I just came in from another meeting. Ano po, just like to confirm, yung outside, off campus po is outside the gate po talaga, ma'am? Literal talaga. Kasi we have community activities with our student orgs as well as our extension. Ah, when you go out of the gate talaga. Okay. Yes. Ah, okay. Oo. Yes. Oo. Okay. Yes, ma'am. So with that po, we need to comply all, no? Even if it's just really literally outside of the campus. Yes po, we have community activities in the community. Actually, we have upcoming.
In front of us, Mintal. Around us, Bago Oshiro. Oh, Bago Oshiro yun dyan. Like for example, kasi may DSWD dyan eh, yung rehab at saka yung juvenile detention. So kung mag-community service kami sa juvenile detention, kailangan pa, outside na yun.
So murag ingana na lang. So kana siya tama, impractical gid na siya. Even ingana outside activity na ba yan na? So mag ano pa. So katong strategy na gi-suggest ni ma'am and then gi-backupan sa inyo ang mga students, that would be a good strategy. Ibutang lang yun siya sa policy, ma'am. Para standard lang siya. Yun lang, standard. Para ano yun, approve sa inyo ang admin na it's okay. So wala naman yung nakabutang sa amuan na dili pwede ang i-group ninyo by SEM ang inyong activities and then yun. Basta lang, na ay parental consent. Notarized. Sana with lawyer na sila dito, no? I'm not aware sa kanilang policy o hindi ko aware.
Never sa akin 6 years of stay sa high school na kailangan
notarized. Yeah, I understand. Kasi ako even kung hindi ko kataga-CHED, murag ano na siya. I don't know sa asa na siya na nilagi anchor nga nung kailangan notarize. Pero na-raise na siya sa during our orientation, pero because if public orientation naman good, approved naman good na siya na policy, maybe we can, yes. So, ang pwede nato buhaton later on is muuban ang UP sa next na revision sa ato ang off-campus na guidelines. And then we will raise that up sa public consultation. So, duha man good na. Pag mag-revise ta og policy, duha ang agian, no? Public consultation, diha pwede pa ta ka-comment for finalization. So kung dili magadtong mga schools, no, mo na, kung unsa na ana didto sa public consultation, dili niya na erase, dili na nila i-revise sa public orientation, that's already the approved na policy. Now, every 5 years na siya, ma'am. This is 2017, so maybe this year or next year mag-revise na sila. Muuban gyud ang UP Min didto. And then muagi sa tagon, I would suggest iagi sa nato consultation para input sa mga estudyante, dal-o nato na dito sa consultation for revision sa ato ang policy. Oh, ang inyong representation dito is your participant institution. Not unless na naging may conduct rin na consultation and then i-gather good ang inputs ninyo sa inyong office sa OSA and then si Ma'am OSA will really attend the consultation and raise that up. Diha ang chance ninyo. Oo. Central. So we will ask if pwede ba magdala ang ano, usually. Yeah. True, true. Estudyante.
A professor, especially yung mga department heads, especially yung mga nalapat na talaga ng mga units and off-campus activities. And at the same time, being the biggest stakeholders ng CHED, which is the students.
Pero pwede na siya buhaton, pero within sa institution, consultation. Na dapat ka nang, in ano yun, katong kung sa yun ay ilang concerns will be, ano, i-carry yun sa, ano, idaloon yun sa amuang consultation. No? So usually, walang estudyante for institutional, yung mga institutional participants man. Pero better yun, ma'am, kuwaon yun ang input sa estudyante. Ah, sayang, wala si ma'am.
Announcement na may public consultation. Pero prior to that,
attendance. Usually attendance. Kaya nga mas ano yung mga knowledgeable talaga sa mga ano concerns.
Ang nalang sa term na sa student council kasi when it comes to hindi man sa pag-compare pero yung pag very different
from, yeah, context dapat ito. The context sa
as a system, depende ng pinakamaliit ng campus with their population.
Yeah.
Ang hindi man 15,000, hindi man 1,400.
Yeah. So are you following the same na student handbook, ma'am, sa UP Min? So pwede mo mag-craft up. Pwede naman pala. Pwede naman pala, ma'am. Oh. Oh, sige lang, ma'am. Pero at least nai ano.
Policy pwedeng i-adopt.
Oo. Pero pwede ding hindi, ma'am. Meron ding.
Pero formal na saying you are adopting this policy.
Dali lang yan, ma'am. Especially if wala talaga silang standard yan, ma'am. Kung walang standard, baka pwedeng kayo lang mag-come up. Okay, especially if walang standard talaga, yung mga templates niyo, pwede na kayo mag-come up na, no? Pero I would consider yung suggestions nila, ma'am, ha? Physician and ang physician is really required, pero yung sa medical clearance and the notarization.
So when is an appropriate time to require the medical certificate? Is it a athletic event?
Yeah. Kana mga trips na more than one day, ay mga tours na more than one day, no, more than one day, ma'am. Oo. Hindi mo nagkailangan talaga yan medical certificate, kaya magsasakay ng eroplano, mga long travels, yung mga ganyan, ma'am. So, kayo na mag-identify niyan, ma'am, ano yung mga specific diyan kasi nakalagay doon if appropriate. So, yeah, pwede. Policy. Oh, yes, ma'am. So, some more questions? Yung iba nga, ma'am, ka-appeal ang neuro. Kasi may case before na meron pala siyang psychological condition, ma'am, or something. Doon sa Manila na nitukar. So, time na mabalik sila, dili siya kabalik, kay advice siya magstay kay may ano. So, hindi yun siya na-check because dili siya parked sa basic. So, ang basic lang man, kanang mga ano. Pero there are schools na gina-appeal nila. Especially ka ng mga OJT. Mga ka pwede mag-OJT na ka ng naakay. Oh, no? So, kailangan gina-check. Pero dili siya required sa CHED. Pero pwede i-consider na sa school. Especially if ka ng mga activities na kailangan gina-check na siya. Silang off-campus na siya. Mula ko kaano kung kinsa ang magano ana, no? Nga naman kinsa. Guidelines. Wala. Hindi ko katubag kay wala yung ano, no? So, kanang mga ingana na arrangement, murag kailangan na kanakabutang na siya sa inyo ang policy. Guidelines talaga, ma'am. Guidelines talaga. So isa-isahin, medyo dako pag anuhon si mama. Sige, ma'am. Siya sa katong range, pareha na medical, 6 months dapat. So, if naapa dito, wala yung problema. No? Katong ano, ang validity sa document, if within pa sa iyahang, dili pa expired, okay lang na siya. Oo. Pero ang activity, hindi naman na-change, only the schedule. Yeah, wala may problema. Pero supplemental lang na siya na letter na you are changing, or not necessary documents, luyo po supplement lang na you are changing the venue, you are changing the schedule, pero same activity lang yun. Yes, true, that's why naana siya.
Have learnings ba na from the community,
bawasan ang ilang quality.
Yeah. So, kato lang. Mana? Okay na. Oh, thank you. Okay.
Thank you.
So I guess there's no more question. Answer na ang mga clarifications and queries from sa audience na nadri karon and also from the Zoom. So at this moment, may I call on Ma'am Stella and our guest speaker to please be here in front for the giving of token and certificate of appreciation. He reads an account certificate.
Okay.
So, certificate of appreciation is presented to Engineer Maria Cristina B. Condes for her valuable insights shared during the forum and consultation on CMO number 63, otherwise known as the Policies and Guidelines for Local Off-Campus Activities as the resource speaker, given this 15th day of April 2024 at CGSS Mini Theater UP Mindanao. Signed, Associate Professor Maria Stella R. Salazar, PhD, Director, Office of Student Affairs, and Professor Lyre Annie E. Murao, PhD, Chancellor UP Mindanao. A round of applause, please. And to formally end today's event, Ma'am Stella will give the closing remarks.
Just get one, ma'am. Ano. Anyway, sana marami tayong napulot sa ating activities ngayon. No? So, na-realize ko, marami tayong hindi isinusulat pero ginagawa natin. And we're gearing towards ISO kasi we're targeting this year to be ISO accredited. Hopefully kasama dyan tong mga policies natin na gagawin for local off-campus activities na marami tayong nakitang insights pero yun nga we're hoping na hindi naman kasi siya totally clear, maraming gray areas gaya nga noon, yun nga kailangan pa ba ng parent consent ang adult, may mga anak na yung iba diyan. So pero kasi we have to strategize, we have to find ways in order to meet the minimum requirement of CHED or substantially, and sinabi nila not substantially comply with the requirement. Okay? So yun yung keyword doon, we substantially comply with the requirement. So let us siguro later on sit down and make a good policy for UP Mindanao or local off-campus activities. So with that, I thank our resource person, I thank the IT office for bringing this online. I thank the staff of Office of Student Affairs, and I thank all of you who attended present here today for attending this forum. With that, I close the program. Thank you.
So that ends the forum and consultation and chat. Thank you, everyone, and have a great day ahead.
Thank you.